Centerline plot is actually very close to what you have seen with the orbit plot, except that the centerline plot is actually helpful to understand what is the average position of the shaft inside the bearing during a phase like a run-up or even constant speed with changing loads or coast down. What happens is that basically the film fluid around the shaft inside the bearing is not uniform. And the shaft will be moving inside the bearing depending on many parameters, actual loads on the shaft, the bearing stiffness, temperature of the oil, rotational speed, whatever. And the centerline plot will show the average position of our shaft during one complete cycle in the measurement plane. As you can see on the right, it can be combined with what we call clearance circle, which helps to visualize the position of the shaft relative to the bearing. So in the display in the right, the dotted line represents the limits of the bearing around the shaft. And you can see in this example that the shaft has been moving during the run-up, run-down phase, but it has never been touching the bearing. If the red line would be touching the black dotted line, it would mean that we would have rub and that the shaft would be touching the bearing. On this centerline plot, we find again same type of information as what we have on the orbit, meaning that we have this X and Y annotation, which shows the angular position of our probes. So in that case, they are positioned at 45 and 135 degrees. And we also see, just like in the orbit, the sense of rotation, which is marked with the arrow here. So let's go a bit further and try to understand how this centerline plot is built and what's the added value. So in this example, I have on the left my shaft, which let's say is lying down in the bearing because there is no motion of the shaft, so there is no oil film under the shaft. And basically, it turns very slowly, still touching the bearing, and I can see the corresponding red cross in my display on the right. So we are really touching the bearing. And then what will happen is that the shaft speed will increase and the oil film will build up under the shaft. So the shaft will move a bit upward in the bearing and rotational speed increases. There might be some side loads during this acceleration process of the shaft rotational speed. So maybe the shaft will be subject to some left and right forces that will make it move inside the bearing. So that is represented on the centerline plot in the right. You can see that the crosses are moving together with the shaft position. And in that position here, we have reached the center position. So there is a good oil film under our shaft. It's turning steadily, fixed speed, no side loads, it's not moving. And what would happen if on top of that, we would add a side load because of some pistons effect or whatever type of load could happen on the shaft, and that the shaft would start moving, that would show up on the centerline plot as yet another segment of the line going along together with the motion of the shaft. So this is how the centerline plot is built. So combination of X and Y probe, average position of the shaft per rotation.